Hey, this is Sarah and Tisha hosting another Cue for Conflict.
Does April 3rd ring a bell to you? Well, if it's not your birthday, then you might have heard of a bigotry called Punish a Muslim Day.
Last month, anonymous letters were sent to people in at least 6 communities in England. Incited were hateful flyers declaring April 3rd as Punish Muslim Day, and that points would be awarded for acts of violence against Islam and Muslims.
Without stating all of them, the authors of the racist flyers offer points for racist acts such as 25 points for pulling the headscarf of a Muslim woman, 50 points for throwing acid in the face of a Muslim, 100 points for beating up a Muslim, 1,000 points for burning or bombing a mosque, and 2,500 points for nuking Mecca.
While many people thought that this only impacted the Muslim community in Britain, other Muslim communities in the United States and in Europe also felt concerned. In the United States, the Council on American Islamic Relations has reported receiving concerned calls from Muslim Americans. And according to the New York Daily News, Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams announced increased security measures at the meeting at the Pakistani American Youth Society in Ditmas Park.
Some also argued that even though that hateful campaign is targeting Muslims, it should be everybody's concern. Because as sad as it can seem, besides Muslim women who are wearing hijabs, other Muslims are not going around with "I am Muslim" written on their foreheads.
Luckily, no one was harmed during April 3rd. However, according to the New York Times, the event caused quite a lot of fear within the community. Many were asking if they were going to be safe and if their children were going to be safe playing outdoor.
Although some people argued that the best way to deal with racist campaigns, such as Punish a Muslim Day, is to ignore them, others were a part of a vast solidarity and acts of kindness campaigns on social media. According to the New York Times, hashtag Love a Muslim Day events were organized along with the Protect a Muslim Day initiative. Helpful guidelines and sensitive reminders were shared on what to do if you witness abuse circulated online. According to the same source, others offered transportation to those scared to take public transportation. Events have also been planned across the UK to show opposition to the threats.
In a more sarcastic tone, on The Daily Show with Trevor Noah, comedian Hassan Minhaj joked that on April 3rd, all Muslims could stay home, Amazon Prime everything they need, catch up on Peaky Blinders, then walk out April 4th and boom, Islamophobia is over. To other non-Muslims, his sarcasm might feel inappropriate, but to Muslims like me, he puts it perfectly. Think of it this way. Islam or Muslims make news when it's about terrorism, violence, abolishing hijab, or war in the Middle East. A large portion of non-Muslims think of Islam as a brutal religion, and Muslim women as being constantly oppressed because they have to wear the hijab.
To make a long story short, the bitter reality is that to many Muslims, every day is a Punish a Muslim Day. According to Pew Research Center, in 2016, there were 127 reported victims of aggravated or simple assault, compared with 91 the year before and 93 in 2001. Adding that, assaults are not the only form of hate crime carried out against Muslims. The most common is intimidation.
So, in order to fight Islamophobia at its root, the state, NGOs, the media, and the people need to come together and promote for an honest and well-grounded portrayal of Muslims in the media and elsewhere. Yes, we're different, but differences are what makes us, us. So to the non-Muslim out there who is still afraid of approaching a Muslim, be curious to know, instead of shouting, go back to your country. As poet Amel Kassir puts it, upon meeting someone new, we ask their names. We do not assign it to them.
This is all for this week's Cure for Conflict. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on other social media platforms.